we're sitting in the middle of a flood.
Disaster doesn't always strike quickly. Sometimes it comes in a slow creep. Communities in seven states along the Mississippi River have watched the waters rise to record levels.
As I look out this river, it speaks back to me and said, look, you think you could control me? I may show you sometimes that you can't.
I've never seen the water that high, ever. It's scary.
We're looking at an epic flood, not only here, but all up and down the Mississippi River.
Did you ever watch Titanic? That's what it feels like. You're gonna sink, you just don't know when.
Everything I own is here. Where else could I go? I figure I gotta stay and look after my own.
You're stuck at the mercy of the water. It's a total loss. I mean, that's the biggest fear. It's tough, especially tough on my son.
A couple weeks ago, was about to flood in our house.
It was up here, wasn't it?
Yes.
It way up there.
As they wait for the waters to recede, friends, families, and strangers up and down the mighty Mississippi band together to protect what's theirs.
The devastation never is fully told. You're talking about years and years and years to recover, and those wounds will be there forever.
Dinner was on the stove, and her 96-year-old mother was on the couch next to her when Marion Carter got a frantic call from her son. He told her a tornado touched down nearby. She barely had time to put the phone down when the windows in her home exploded. The force of the twister pinned Marion and her mother under the couch and the rubble of what used to be her home. Marion and her mother survived, and when she talks about the story now, there's tears of joy for the neighbors who dug through the wreckage to save them. In a way, Marion Carter lived in two houses, one built with bricks and mortar, and one built on faith. In the end, faith survived.
Poster. There's flies in the kitchen. I can hear them in there buzzing. And I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person go to work in the morning and come home in the evening and have nothing to say? It's a hard way to go.
Holy smokes, no way.